Alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'du qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Muhammadur Rasulullah walladhina ma'ahu ashidda'u ala al-kuffar ruhama'u baynahum tarahum rukka'an sujjada yabtaghuna fadlan min Allahi wa ridwana. Wa qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam أصحابي كالنجوم فبأيهم اقتديتم اهتديتم وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تسبوا أصحابي فوالذي نفسي بيده لو أن أحدكم أنفق مثل أحد ذهبا ما أدرك مد أحدهم ولا نصيفه أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما والتقدر اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Respected brothers, sisters, youngsters, ulamas, elders, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before we enter into our topic, I'd like to remind everyone of the best favor that he has provided us with. We are sitting in one of the best places in the world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen us to sit in this best place. The place which we are sitting in is known as the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has favored us and chosen us to come to the best place in the world, which is the masjid, which is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say alhamdulillah. Without Allah choosing us, there's no way we can even do our salah. Even if we perform our salah, you've got to know that it is the favor of Allah upon us. It is Allah who has given us the permission, then we can do our salah. But a man and a woman, a male and a female, every person needs to have the intention. Once we make our intentions, like you made your intentions today, and because you made your intentions, the rest of it was fulfilled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say alhamdulillah. In places and gatherings like this, my brothers, I'll tell you another good news. The angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have surrounded this place. Literally, there are thousands of angels surrounding this gathering. Did you know that? Thousands of angels are here right now. And they encircle one on top of the other and they reach the Arsh al-Azim. Allah is Alimul Ghaybi wa Shahada. He knows the future, He knows the present, and He knows the past. Despite knowing why the angels are here for, He asks and questions the angels. He says, Oh my angels, you have come from Isha'at al-Islam, where people are sitting in one of my houses. What are those people gathered there for? Why have they gathered there for? So the one of the angels, he says, Ya Rabbi, O my Lord, the only reason they have gathered there is to enter into Jannah and save themselves from Jahannam. Is this why we're here, all here for? Yes or no? We want to enter into where? Jannah. Not Jahannam. Someone said Jahannam here. We want to enter into Jannah. And we want to protect ourselves from Jahannam. Because you may say, a lot of people, they talk about success. Some people say, this person is extremely successful. Highly established person. We call a person successful sometimes. Why? Because he's got a couple of houses. Or he has a couple of businesses. or he is an owner of certain amount of land, or he has 25 children, or he has children who have acquired degrees and doctorates. People call them to be successful people. But Allah does not say that these are the people who are successful. Because Allah says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. The word faz and foz in Arabic means to be successful. And the word opposite that is khasir, loser. So Allah says, there's no one who is successful. The only one who is successful is the one who has saved himself from the fire of hell, which is Jahannam. From where, everybody? Jahannam. So Allah says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Whoever has protected himself through his a'mals and actions from Jahannam and entered into paradise, then he is successful. What does that mean? It also means that one till death cannot be successful until he reaches into Jannah. Because he may have an accident in the middle. He may fall into the trap of shaitan anytime. That is why we need to continue to do good until we reach into Jannah. So the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they said, oh Allah, these people in Isha'at al-Islam, or in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are gathered because they want Jannah and they want to save themselves from Jahannam. You know what Allah says? Allah says, oh my angels, you be my witness for the day of judgment, that these same people who are sitting down and want to go into Jannah and want to avoid Jahannam, you be my witness that I have made Jannah wajib on them, compulsory on them, and I have made Jahannam haram on them. SubhanAllah. This is the good news that is taking place right now between the angels and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Furthermore, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that there are certain individuals in the gathering who have just sat down without the intention of going into Jannah and avoiding Jahannam. Ya Rabbi, what is going to happen to that person? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, oh my angels, be my witness, because I have made Jannah wajib on the others and made Jahannam haram on the others, the person who does not even have the intention, but because he is accompanying the good people, I make Jannah wajib for him and Jahannam haram for him as well, subhanahu. Can you imagine? So sitting down in gathering such as these, even without an intention, you also get the benefit of what the benefit is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the others. My brothers, we have been bestowed with so many different favors. And if we talk about favors, it will be a different subject. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ لَكُنْتُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ لَكُنْتُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Had it been not the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, then you would have been amongst the losers. Can you imagine? Allah's favor is upon us. That is why we are living the way we are living. We are breathing. We can see. We can hear, we can talk, we can have a conversation. All of this is because Allah's favor is upon us. One of the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the companionship of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is our subject today. Before we get into the subject of the 10 who were given the glad tidings of paradise, we want to know who is a company, or who is a Sahabi, or who are the Sahabas? Sahabas are those who at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they took the Shahada. They believed in Allah and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also they died as a Muslim. So remember, they were Muslims at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they also died in Islam. Allah mentions several verses in the Quran, directly and indirectly, regarding the values and the virtues of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. Who were they? Where were they? They were those who lived every day and every night with the best man created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the ones who saw with their raw eyes the best man, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the ones, when the Prophet went through hardship, they also went through the hardship with the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the ones who did not worship Allah looking into the information or Googling or texting or getting a printout. They were the ones who worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly by seeing the Holy Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the ones, the Sahabas, they were the ones who were available at the time when the revelation of the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took place on the Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They, the Sahabas, are the ones who traveled with the Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they knew how to travel, what to do at the time when they should travel, before traveling and after traveling. They were the ones who were guided directly by the Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was directly guided by Hazrat Jibra'il alayhi salam, and Hazrat Jibra'il alayhi salam directly informed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any hijab. They are the companions and the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. They are the ones who sat with the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine sitting with the Prophet. We can never achieve sitting with the Prophet, knowing something directly from Prophet, but they were the ones who sat directly in front of the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the ones who copied each and every fashion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and my sisters, today we have vast amount of fashion in the world. And every week fashion changes. But the best of fashion is the fashion of the Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in the Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. Whoever wants to be successful in the hereafter, in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he must take as an example Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahabas, who were they? They were the ones who fulfilled the conditions of going into Jannah. What is the condition to go into Jannah, my brothers and my sisters? The first condition after Shahada is to have love for Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did you know that? After the Shahada, the first condition of going into Jannah is to love Allah and the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so many ahadith and so many incidents where the companions have proved to Allah and his Rasul that they loved Allah and his Rasul more than their own children, their own family members and their wives as well. There was a Sahabi who came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I love you so much. Whenever I go back to my house, that love, it decreases. When I come back to you and I'm next to you, Ya Rasulullah, my love increases. I love you so much, Ya Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wanted to test him. He wanted to test him. And he said, are you sure you love me more than anyone else? You love Allah more than anyone else? You love me more than anyone else? So the Sahabi said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. Na'am. Bala ya Rasulullah. Oh, the messenger of Allah, I do. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's in Arabic, the hadith, it'll take too long. The Prophet said, then go and murder your father. The Prophet said, go and kill your father. Killing is not allowed in Islam, is it? Is it allowed? Why don't you say it loud? No, it's not allowed. In chapter number 6, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if anyone murders anyone, it is like they have murdered the entire mankind. And if you saved anyone, it is like you have saved the entire mankind. How beautiful our religion is. Say subhanallah and say alhamdulillah. My brothers and my sisters, the Prophet said he wanted to test him. So he said, go and murder your father. This Sahabi did not even wait for a second. He turned around and with the intention of killing his father, he made his way. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw that this Sahabi is too strong in his love for Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So after a little while, he called him back. He said, oh my Sahabi, oh my companion, I was doing this to test your iman. Test the love of yourself for Allah. Test the love of your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, al-mar'u ma'a man ahabba fi yawm al-qiyamah. He said, al-mar'u ma'a man ahabba fi yawm al-qiyamah. Those who love a person, he will be resurrected on the day of judgment with that person. And that in this incident, who did this Sahabi prove that he loved? He loved Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that means this Sahabi will be with who? Allah and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment. My brothers and my sisters, they fulfilled the condition of going into Jannah. And they are not those who chose themselves to be companions. They are those who were chosen by Allah to become the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in the Quran, he says, Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalatah. Allah knows best to whom he would give the responsibilities of carrying out the message of the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah knew very well with regards to who will be able to take this burden of carrying on the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in the Quran in another verse as well, because one of the conditions of being successful is to thank Allah, to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the companions were the ones who were truly grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَعْلَمَ بِالشَّاكِرِينَ. Allah says, does Allah not know? Does Allah not have the most knowledge of who will be grateful to him and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He knew and chose the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to accompany him. Allah says in one of the verses of the Quran, confirming the akhlaq of the sahabas. Just imagine, me and you have not been confirming the akhlaq of the sahabas. It is not another prophet. It was not Musa. It was not Adam. It was not Isa, none of them. But Allah himself has confirmed the akhlaq and the sifat and the character of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What did he say? He says, Muhammadur Rasulullah. He states Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Allah confirms this first. وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ. And those with him. And who are they? Who are those with him? Sahabas. Who are those with him? Sahabas. أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ. They are strict with the kuffar. When they want to do anything evil to deen, they stood up for their deen. أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ. They protected the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is confirming that they've done their job correctly. Allah has confirmed this. رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ And Allah confirms that they are merciful in their hearts. Subhanallah. Allah says that the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ They are merciful amongst one another. تَرَاهُمْ رُكَّعًا سُجَّدًا Subhanallah. Allah says that you will always see them in the state of ruku'. Allah is confirming. Allah khuira. Tatarare shob shomoy faiba. Either ruku khurer or tawa sujda khurer shob shomoy. Taragum rukka'an sujjada. But some people, they may do ruku' and sujood for other purpose. Probably they want to get married. So the to-be father-in-law is just sitting there, so he does really nice ruku' and really nice sujda. So Allah confirmed that they did not do the ruku' and sujood, or they do not do this ruku' and sujood for any other purpose but the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ruku' they did was only for the pleasure of Allah. The sujood they did was only for the pleasure of Allah. يَبْتَغُونَ فَضْلًا مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانًا With the intention that they will receive huge amount of reward from Allah on the day of judgment and in this world. وَرِضْوَانَ And the happiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What more happiness, what more success is there than the happiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and my sisters. So these qualities were confirmed by not me and you and not confirmed by any other prophets, but they were confirmed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Kitabullah.